prepared do you think your graduates are to know what kind of program they want to go to? Do you feel, is that redundant of something they're learning? Do they distinguish between what they're going to find at a junior college, what they're going to get at a four-year regional, what they're going to find at a liberal arts school, what a BFA is compared to a BA? Because what I find when students arrive in my office is I spend more of my time talking with their families and with the student about how do I go about seriously studying theater and where do I go to match my level of preparation to study, as opposed to where do I go to feel overwhelmed and be told to change my major or to feel bored and feel like dad was right, this wasn't going to give me a job. Is that kind of workshop something that you think would be beneficial for your students? That,
yes.
Yeah.
What components would help? What types of things could a group cover in that kind of workshop?
Well, I live in an environment where the theater we have is extremely antiquated. There's no light board, there's no sound board. My kids don't even know what real theater is. They have no place to even go experience what real theater is.
So something where they were leaving
an overview
and touring?
Yeah, a tour to show up their little mouse would be hanging over. It would be awesome.
And you coupled with maybe a performance.
Absolutely.
Where do you think the line is between inspiring them to continue to study and intimidating them into thinking, well, all I've had is this stage and this barn? So there's no way I'm going to be able to do this if that's what it looks like. That's a line I'm always interested in because I see so many high school students decide that they won't study theater because they feel like they're so far behind already, they'll never be competitive.
One of the things I'm trying to see is we're starting with theater programming and I'm like right where I'm doing this. My stage is wherever there's an empty spot in the building. And so one of my objectives this year is to show them what real theater looks like and trying to work connections here in the city where I can get on a college campus so they can see, because I have some people that if they could see a scene shop, they would be the happiest people on the planet. But all they think, because they're the loudest people in the beginning drama class, you know, the actor people, and I'm more of a tech person, and I'm like, I'm going to show you what a real scene shop looks like, and the really cool parts of design, and how you figure lighting loads, because there's some gentlemen in there that would light their fire to know those opportunities are out there, but all we hear in the high school drama classroom are, you know, the people who are emoting all over the place, because we're just beginning. And so I think that would be a phenomenal opportunity because there are so many venues for people with those talents now that have nothing to do with theater.
I may be jumping ahead, but we're going to talk about Mike. But last year we went to State at TCC, and my kids were just, first of all, amazed that the community college had the program that they did, the theater, the facility, and their tech scene shop. You've never seen a scene shop until you've seen theirs. And with colleges opening their doors to things like one-act play and allowing us to come in, my kids would have never seen what that scene shop looked like or that school or even thought to be interested. When instead I had a couple of kids that said, I'm going to check this out. I'm going to check Tulsa Community College out. So I think those kinds of relationships will be going to get the kids, again, more aware of what is available to them. And you know, that's kind of still small pond. So.
What about the flip side of that? What about a program that comes to your school and embraces rough theater as it is and shows them that their theater is a space? That this is a company that is prepared to show you professional training with your resources, with your space, with your seat shop or lack thereof. Is that
your chest?
I think Cimarron Opera. What's the opera that we use around Cimarron?
Well, there's Cimarron Circuit Opera.
Cimarron.
Okay. I teach speech. Circuit Opera, they used to come around and they still may do some scenes. And they set up a full set
I'm from a very small school in northwest Oklahoma where there's nobody wants to come because it's 3 hours away from Oklahoma City, even. But Lyric has come out to our school a couple of times, and for our whole school, K through 12, and they have a program K through 6, and they have a program 7 through 12. And like last year was compared for the older kids was comparing Romeo and Juliet to West Side Story, and they sang and had costume changes. And, I mean, and we have a little stage, so and they did it all right there. It was very interesting. And I don't know, I don't think it cost anything, but I'm not sure. Our music program put it on.
I think that is, you know, endowed by somebody. So I'm not sure.
Yeah, but I mean, they've come out the last 2 years. That so.
And you felt like that was incredibly
our kids really, I mean, even our older kids, because this is the first year Arnett has ever had a speech and drama class that's competing. I mean, I've had a speech class for just speech, but not able to go to competitions. This is the first year we're doing this. And so, but even the kids that had never seen any kind of production, it held their interest. And it comes with teaching guides that you can email all the teachers, and so they can prepare them ahead of time of what they're going to see. And it was very interesting. We were going to do it again this year, but it was the exact same one as they did last year. So, but the kid, the younger group last year did Annie, Get Your Gun. And so our music teacher, because she teaches K through 6 music, she had them all watch the movie before they came. And they'll have audience participation. They come out and ask, let some little kids come on stage and do things. And it's been very interesting. So you might look into Mr. Blackett.
In an effort to promote self-plugging on my part and also to just be Captain Obvious here, one of the issues that I see that we're all talking about in a strange way is your activity and our activity is so different than every other activity, and there's not a national standard. Like if we go play a basketball game anywhere in the state, we know how big that court's going to be. The stages are all different, the lighting is all different, the sound is all different, and that's one of the challenges I face. I'm with the OSSAA, the Oklahoma Secondary School Activity Association at the high school level, and we're the ones that put on the qualifying tournaments for speech and debate as well as the one-act plays. One of the things I would, the reason I'm sitting here because the name cooperation between high school and college jumped off the page of me. We have had some great cooperation between the OSSAA and colleges, UCO and East Central, and you've judged for us, and you know, I mean, we've had some great experiences. And I would like to encourage you all, if you are at a university level and you do have a stage of any type that would be helpful to us, we're always looking for sites. We're always looking for locations that are friendly to our organization. I'll give you an example. This year on October 9th, 10th, and the 11th, we're going to have 12 locations for one-act plays. And October 23rd, 24th, and 25th, one location for each of those days for state one-act. And as Ms. Burton referred to, we did have it at Tulsa Community College last year. That was simply a phone call from a gentleman there. I made contact, and next thing you know, hey, we'd love to host a 6A state for you. And the kids were blown away. I was blown away, like Ms. Burton. I'd never been in the Tulsa Community College. I've never been to every place in here. But it's very exciting for me when I get a call from, like, Richard, who called me last summer and said, hey, we'd sure like to help out with the OSSA's One Act if you guys got anything. And they've got a wonderful theater there in East Central. We're going to try to make that happen. So if you are at a college and have a facility, now keep in mind, I understand what a burden it is on you guys. For us, my high school teachers call me all that. Well, why don't you just call OU and tell them you need their stage? Well, unfortunately, you know, they're kind of doing their own shows. And for us to just ask you to put everything aside and let them take over your stage for a day or two, they don't understand. The other complicating thing is, we don't pay tons of money. We pay someone like $100 to be the boots on the ground person, and we got a little money to buy some spike tape, but we really don't rent the place. We don't do that. We charge our plays $75. You know, it doesn't do it. You do the math. If we send 5 plays somewhere and the schools are being charged $75, by the time you pay your judges, there's nothing left. And we don't pay the judges very much either. So it's a labor of love, but if you are in a situation where you have a facility, the one thing I can promise you, it is a great recruiting tool. Whether you know it or not, and I've only taught high school for 21 years, I taught adjunct college for a few years, but I know how hard it is to get kids on your campus that are interested in the things that you do. I promise you, if you host one of these things and work with us, we're going to put 5 or 6 or 8 schools with kids who do this activity on your stage. And you would be surprised how many of them are wandering around backstage going, wow, look at the scene, like you said, the scenery. We don't have a light board, and they're interested. And we even allow you to set up a table in the lobby saying, hey, if you want to come to TCC or East Central, or we're fine. We don't want you directly walking up to get to offer scholarships, obviously. But if you want to set up an information table or put something in the packet, we don't even have a problem with that. So once again, just, and I know it's a self-plug, but if any of you want us to be on your campus, please contact me. I'm at the OSSAA and would love to visit with you. And I want to thank those of you who have had us at your school in the past. If you don't mind us shutting your production down for a day or two, we'll put some kids on your campus, and it would help us out, and I think ultimately it would help you guys out.
I'd like to kind of jump off on that, and I think a lot of us in the high schools recognize that the opportunities in Oklahoma for colleges, for our students, are maybe the most appropriate and the best opportunities for them. But every junior and senior that I know is thinking, I'm going to leave here, right? Freedom is equated with I'm going to get away and out. And the thing that keeps my students here in Oklahoma at the places that are the best for them are these outreaches. So every time I have a kid go to a local or regional college, it's because we went there to do something. And they saw the place, and they saw what the opportunities were. And we know that's a wonderful thing for them. They still have their family home support. They're getting the education that they want and that they need. A lot of times they're not recognized.